Hello Internet, I'm Luke.
And I'm Matt.
And we're here to talk to you today about the jewel in the Fender crown, the American Ultra series of guitars. I obviously have a Strat.
And I have the Telecaster.
In that magnificent butterscotch blonde.
Yep, the beautiful black binding to outline that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good thing to look at, for
absolutely.
Sure.
Absolutely.
What do you like about them?
So it's pretty much a contemporary take on what is otherwise a classic. So you have things like a thinner neck and a flatter fretboard, which is very much to my liking. If you don't want to wrestle with like the bigger, chunkier baseball bat necks, you have pretty much a little shred stick in a Fender package.
And compound radius too, right?
Yep, 10 to 14, so good for cording up here, and then a little bit of lead and solo work up the further end of the fretboard.
Smooth.
Yeah.
Which is only, only kind of enhanced by the heel, that magnificent ergonomic little heel that
you
get and all these kind of things. It's,
yeah,
it makes it a beautiful thing to play on. I am head over heels in love with these colors too. That's the thing that I like.
The Texas tee.
Texas tee is a ridiculous
color. Easily one of
color.
The best colors that they've brought out in a good while.
Mm. Sometimes it's green, sometimes it's black, sometimes it's, you know, Rambos.
A little bit of everything in between.
Yeah, and like that, it's, you know, so it should be. If it's going to be the kind of the peak of guitar existence, then why shouldn't it be a hell of a thing to look at?
For sure, for sure.
You know what I mean? Sparkly gold logo on the headstock, which is schmick.
So with the American Ultras, much like the Elites and whatnot beforehand, they had the noiseless pickups. This is the fourth generation of that.
Mm.
To my ear, they are quite dynamic, maybe in comparison to some previous generations.
Yeah.
You know, they're a fairly particular sound for a certain kind of crowd, but I feel like these are a bit more versatile.
Yeah, a lot more lively, a lot more attitude, and especially for a noiseless pickup, you know what I mean? They kind of get a bad rap for being dry and all that kind of stuff in a noiseless world entirely. But yeah, I mean, the Tele sounds like a Tele. It has that kind of attitude. Strat sounds like a Strat. It's an angry little thing if you dig in, for sure.
Another great feature of the American Ultras is the S1 switching. A little different between the Stratocaster and the Telecaster. With the Telecaster, when not activated, you're in series wiring. So essentially, your typical bright, sparkly sounds you expect to hear from a Telecaster. When activated, you're in parallel wiring, so it gets a little bit more mid-forward, a little bit warmer and rounder. What about the Strat?
In a Strat, you drop your neck pickup into position one and position two with that switch. So position one gives you this really kind of beefy, almost humbucker kind of bridge pickup sound. And then in position two, a little bit more, again, of that kind of funky mid-range stab, that kind of Ike Turner thing.
Yeah, another thing that they actually both share is the treble bleed circuitry. So essentially what that does, when you roll off your tone, it doesn't actually kill the highs, it's a bit more of a balanced sound.
I guess the thing that I like most about these guitars is that for all the sort of modernity and, you know, R&D and science about them, they still just kind of feel like a classic guitar, you know what I mean? If you're looking for a Strat, you're not necessarily looking for something that's like, you know, tricked up and all that kind of thing. But if you want that kind of stuff, it's on tap, you know what I mean? The compound radius fretboard, super comfortable heel, noiseless pickups, close your eyes, it sounds like something from history.
Exactly right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So ultimately, it's a successful design in that way, you know what I mean? And it's not just a kind of a robot.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, it still feels like your typical classic sort of Strat or Tele that you would be used to, but it just has that little extra bit of playability if you need it.
Mm. And completely different from the rest of the line. There's nothing about sort of American performers or a professional series guitars about these. They're very different animals. So like, if you're in the market for that kind of thing, definitely worth having a run on one.
Yeah, for sure.
Just as a point of difference, you know what I mean? They're a completely different animal, and they deserve to be given attention. Pretty much all of the American series, American Ultra series guitars will be listed on our website, cranbourne.com.au. You can have a look before you come in and wrestle the thing. And have a look. We'll see you next time. Cheers.
Mm-hmm.